is the fourth installment of the Dragon Warrior series on the NES. In Japan, the Dragon Warrior series is called Dragon Quest, and after the fourth installment of the game, it was called Dragon Quest in the States when it was originally States from Japan. They renamed it Dragon Warrior from the beginning. I'm not entirely sure why, but that's what they did. This is an epic story that is told in five different chapters, and accurately enough, the remake on the Nintendo DS is called Dragon Quest IV: Chapters of the Chosen. Chapters of the Chosen. I'll have to look. I think it's Chapters of the Chosen. So, we start off with our Purple Knight, Ragnar, as he is on a quest to save the children that are being kidnapped. So he has to investigate that and say, get out of my way. Save the children. Story is a pretty quick one and can be beaten pretty fast. A splendid castle awaits. I wish to be a royal soldier. Say, can you take me along? If you say yes, really, I shall follow you then. So you go walk away, and he's like really old, so it takes forever. And you're like, okay, what's going on? Gasp, gasp, too tough for an old man. Go on alone. Taxes low. Unfortunately, he can't spend much on your equipment. Does he want these children saved or not? Accumulate gold to buy more powerful weapons and armor. Be sure to equip yourself with them after you buy them. Okay, I know. Let's go fight some baddies outside. Are you the greeter? Yeah, you're the greeter. I live here, I know where. Chapter tells the story of different characters. This is Ragnar's chapter. This is Ragnar's theme in the overworld. And each character or group of characters has their own specific themes. Oh no, slimes. What am I gonna do? Slimes are the weakest enemy in this game. I got 4 gold pieces though. Stag beetles and slimes. They're ganging up on me already. So yeah, the first 4 games, when they were ported over to the States, they were called Dragon Warrior instead of Dragon Quest. I think the first one was called Dragon Warrior because your goal in the first game was to defeat the dragon. Signpost, report the sightings of suspicious people. The King of Berlin. What about a warrior that dresses entirely in purple? Is that bar for the course in Berlin? Must be. But the funny thing is, I'm not super familiar with 2 and 3, but in Dragon Warrior 4, dragon in the game is actually he's out to help you in your quest, so I'm not sure. Dragon Quest makes much more sense as a game title, and I don't honestly know why they would have changed the title. I mean, I get changing the title, like, if there's a culture reason. is a day-night system, and they really make use of that, because different scenarios happen at night versus during the day. Oh, we leveled up. Yeah. We are on our way. All these slimes are toast. Stay in an inn and make it daytime again, or you can walk around outside until it turns daytime again. Staying at an inn fully heals you. Okay, yeah, there's no one. There's a well. Can I look in there? Or is that the DS version? I think that's the DS version. Monsters seem to be getting stronger. Just a fountain of specifics. Thanks a lot, man. Whoa. Let's go in the store. What up? I'm close for the day. Come back tomorrow. Not like, hey, how'd you get in here? Forget you. I'm gonna have to go talk to your sleeping family. This is normal. Certainly, I'm not a suspicious character. I want to go to the bathroom, but I'm too scared. Oh, poor kid. Who sleeps like that? What's in your drawers? Nothing special. Nothing special. Do you guys have anything special? Suspicious. That's Berlin Castle. Thanks. Is that... Did you get a concussion? That is all you can seem to say. I got you off kilter. Oh, okay. Hey, what's up? Oh, guarding isn't fun. So the king's chambers are... something in one of these drawers. Nothing special. similarity, I find. The present weather resembles that of past times when monsters reigned. There's monsters outside. Maybe you should go outside once in a while. There's monsters out there that would totally, you know, put a cap on your hypothesis there. This cave has tons of monsters in it. It's a good thing we leveled up. We would be in dire straits if we were still level 1, let me tell you. That's not true. Ragnar is just excellent. He's got a sword. He's got purple. It's awesome. Stop healing. Battle is never gonna end. Stop healing. Goodness. Well, everybody, this is gonna take forever. Finally. Alright, level up again. Level up again, level up this. Work like modern RPGs. You level up very fast. start. Hey, I got 40 gold pieces. Awesome. Boy, these are heavy. You level up pretty quickly in frequency for the start, but then after, it kind of progressively takes more and more experience points to level up as you go. And every time you gain a level, the more experience points are required. But with each level, your stats improve. Stats. And on the bottom is the total level of experience points that I've accumulated so far. I'm a male. Well, Ragnar's a male. Copper sword, leather armor. I need to get some more equipment if I'm gonna go prancing around fighting the real monsters. Think first off. That's the thing about these old school RPGs is they were notorious for their random encounters. Random encounters is basically just the more you step in an open world, the more chance you have to run into an enemy. Now, it gets a lot of slack, but the one thing I liked about Zelda 2 was that the enemies, they kind of appeared randomly, but you could see them on the map and you could try to avoid them. These ones are just invisible. Boy, those guys took a lot out of me. This one here, and I'll keep posting. I want to play this entire game all the way through, and have it as a more of an episodic thing. So.